Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I want to tell you something in the house, our brethren in the house. I'd like you to listen to something. Last Sunday, after the service, a sister called me, and she joined us on YouTube, and she was sharing a testimony with me. She said, Apostle, did you and Pastor B sit down together to plan the way your messages will be? Because the way you people minister is like you go somewhere, you plan it, you say, okay, Pastor B, you do this one, I will come and do this one. I said, in fact, if you see Pastor B asking, sometime in a week, self, maybe it's only once that we are going to talk, and that talk may be just test message. Look, when God have you in mind, he arranged things to favor you. When God have things in mind, he brings the word that you need for the season to you. He brings it to you. I'm telling you. He brings it to you. That is God. He's, when God was sending angel Gabriel to Mary, God knew where Mary would be, knew what Mary was going through, knew the word that Mary needed, and God gave him that word. Sometimes what we want may not be what we need, and God have a way of programming us for what we need. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. He said he will give you a comforter. A comforter. A comforter. He will send a comforter to you. He will bring a comforter to you that will do the job that no other person you think or you thought would be able to do it. The comforter will do it easily. It is my prayer that God will meet you in that area of your need. The comforter will become available to you in the name of Jesus. Ah, my God and my Father. Listen, the Lord gave me a prayer to pray tonight. And the prayer that we'll be praying tonight is titled, Strength is Restored. Strength is restored. I'd like you to say it 7 times to yourself. My strength is restored. 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 In the name of Jesus, as you have declared it, so shall it be. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Acts of Apostles chapter 3, Acts of Apostles chapter 3 verse 7, our pastor just talked about, he just talked about comforter. What will this comforter come and do? What will the comforter do? Why is there need for comforter? Why is there need for comforter? Why is there need? God, why do we need this comforter? Why do you need it? Why do I need the comforter? Because the comforter you need in the area of comfort you may need may be different, very clearly different from my own area that I need comfort. In Acts chapter 3, verse 7, a man needed something. A man needed something. A man needed something that should ordinarily be available to him, but he lacked that thing. And he needed comforters to appear on the scene in order to give him that which he lacked, that which he needed but was not there at the time. Acts chapter 3, verse 7. And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up, and immediately his feet and his ankles, his feet and his ankle bones received strength. Tonight, Maria do Casaida, may God restore your strength. I pray for someone under the sound of my voice. May your strength be restored to you. The Lord said to me that tonight he is going to restore strength to people. He will restore strength. When Peter and John took the lame man by the hand, the Bible says that they lifted him up. His feet and his ankle bones received strength. Strength. Ordinarily, you know what? That particular man was in a condition of lameness. Why? Because strength was missing. Strength was missing. Strength to forge ahead. Strength to move on. Strength to run. Strength to overtake. Strength to serve God. Strength to rise. Strength to increase. He lacked strength. No more energy. No more strength. He was already weak. His legs that were supposed to carry him could not carry him. Are you getting what I'm saying? Strength was missing from areas where there should have been strength. Lameness persisted. Can I pray for someone under the sound of my voice? In the name that is above every name, as you hear me, I speak into your spirit, man. I speak into your ears. Receive strength. Receive strength. Receive strength. Receive strength. Receive strength in the name of Jesus Christ. The enemy stole strength that was meant to be at his feet. You know, the legs were ordinarily supposed to carry this guy. His legs were supposed to be the one to carry him. But the enemy stole his strength. He stole the strength from the area where strength was needed most. I decree strength back into your life. I decree strength back into your marriage. I decree strength back into your business. I decree strength back into your life, spirit, soul, and body. Receive strength in the name of Jesus. Ah, my God. Can I pray for you, beloved? In any area of your life where the enemy has stolen your strength, I decree now, as an oracle of God, let strength be restored. Let strength be restored. Let strength be restored in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your strength be restored. Let your strength come back to you. The Bible said that they were at the beautiful gate. The man was expecting arms. Give me arms. I need money. Give me arms. And they looked at the man. They said to him, look on us. Look on us. And the man looked at him, fastening his eyes on them, expecting to receive money from them. And the Bible said that they said to the man, silver and gold I don't have. We don't have silver and gold, but what we have, we will give you. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, rise up and walk. From the moment they mentioned Jesus of Nazareth, strength had already come, but the man was still there. The Bible said they grabbed him. They took hold of him. They lifted. They were the comforter that man needed. At that point in time, many people, even Jesus entered that temple. Jesus entered and came out of that temple in the days of Jesus. The man was there, but the day his comforters came, that day, things changed for him. Life changed for him. I pray for you today. May your strength be restored to you now. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, let your spiritual strength be restored. In the name of Jesus, let your financial strength be restored. In the name of Jesus, let strength be restored in your marriage. Be restored in your union. In the name of Jesus. There are some people like Pastor, there are some people, it is just one answer to prayer. If God answered this prayer, Apostle, you don't understand. If God answered this prayer, God understands. God understands. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. Let your strength be restored. Let your strength, your spiritual strength, your marital strength, your financial strength, your strength in your prayer life, strength in your study life, be restored in the name of Jesus. Ah, manda kasiada bayada. Let strength be restored to your health. Let your bones receive strength. Let your liver, your kidney, let your brain, your mind receive strength. Receive strength. Receive strength in your kidney. Receive strength in every fiber of your being, from the crown of your head to the very sole of your feet. Now, in the name of Jesus, receive strength. In the name of Jesus, receive strength. The Bible said that the men, when the men of David, when the Amalekite raised down Ziklag, the Bible said they wept until they have no strength. Strength is powerful. Strength. It is strength that makes you to wake up and stand. It is strength. I pray for you today in the name of Jesus. Let your strength be restored 10 times more than before. Let your strength be restored 100-fold more than before. Let your energy be restored in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. It is not over with you. In the name of Jesus, let your strength be restored in the name of Jesus. Can I pray for you? Let strength be restored to those areas where you have been unable to move forward. Areas where you have been unable to move forward. Anakoseke bayada lekuska. Wherever you are joining me from, wherever you have connected with this voice of prayers, in the name of Jesus, in any area where you are supposed to move forward, but strength has weakened you. Strength, no strength. I pray for you now in the name of Jesus. Let strength come to you. Let strength come to you. Let strength be restored to you now in the name of Jesus Christ. Today, I decree restoration. Receive restoration for every area of your life where your strength was stolen away. Receive restoration of strength. Where your strength has been depleted, receive restoration of strength in the name of Jesus Christ. Ando koshabala bayada, rogo sokete lebrege degeliada bakasayada, yeketo zosekete liada gayada. Receive restoration of whatever greatness you once had. Oh yes. The greatness you once had, but later you lost it, and you are like, God, what is going on? Receive the greatness. Receive strength to rise. Receive strength to soar in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Ando kosoke liada bakatayada, la ketosi paradia de kasaida, le kushamande kesiada bakayada. Receive restoration for the heights that were taken away from you before now. Those greatness that were taken away, those giftings that were taken away, those abilities that were taken away. Now receive restoration of them. Receive strength for them. Receive strength for them in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible said the disciples of Jesus, they got to a point, when before they had that encounter with Jesus, that they Peter and his brothers, plus his partners, they had fished all through the night. They caught nothing. You know, sometimes there are areas in our life that we look around and say, well, God, you have not done something in this area. God, you have not done something in this area. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. The Bible said Jesus looked at them and said, hello, have you caught anything? He said, well, we've toiled all night. He said, launch down your net for a catch. He said, we've toiled all night. Master, don't worry, finish your message and we will go. We know how business is this season. we know. You need to see some people explain COVID. And the COVID situation has made things hard. The COVID situation has made their business dead. The COVID situation. In the name of Jesus, I pray for you. In the midst of Thomas, the Bible said, as they persecuted the Israelites in the land of Egypt, he said, the more they persecuted them, the more they increased, the more they grew. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. Receive strength to soar. Receive strength to rise. Receive strength to rise. Receive strength to rise in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive restoration for the areas of your life where your advantages have been taken away from you before. Any area of your life where your advantage has been taken away from you, receive strength. Receive strength now. Receive strength now. In the name of Jesus. let me quickly say here, be careful whenever the enemy makes an attempt on the area of your strength. Be very careful. I was listening to R.O.W. Schambach so many years ago, and he was explaining how the devil can take away strength from people. And he said one way the devil takes strength away from many people is to steal their joy, and it's the truth. Is to steal their joy. Once the devil succeeds in stealing away their joy, he has taken them. He has taken over. That devil is a liar. Your joy will not be stolen. I speak to your life. Let joy be restored to you. Let joy be restored to you. Nehemiah chapter 8 verse 10. The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength. And Psalm 51, he said, restore to me the joy of my salvation. Restore. The joy of the Lord is my strength. Your joy will not be taken by the devil. Any way the enemy have taken your joy, any way the enemy have taken your joy, today in the name of Jesus, I command the joy to be restored. In the name of Jesus, it is the Spirit of Christ that is the Spirit of joy. Let that joy be restored to you now in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Mandoko shaba da ba ya de ke soliada. Roboko soteliada da ba ka shodeliada ba. When your joy goes, your strength goes. That devil is a liar. I speak to you now. Are you still there? I speak to you now in the name that is above every name. Every stagnation that have been packaged for you, every sadness that have been packaged for you, every depression that have attacked you, it's a spirit. Today, I address that spirit to let you go, to let you go, to let you go in the name of Jesus. When the enemy steals your strength, especially your spiritual strength, you know, spiritual strength is not what car can bring, it's not what things can bring. You know, when he steals your spiritual strength, you know, he is trying to stop your journey, he's trying to stop your rising, especially your spiritual rising. When he takes your strength, he is taking away your ability to rise again. Because if you have strength, then you can bounce back. You get my point? You can bounce back. But I'm telling you today, in the name of Jesus, God is a God of restoration. In the name of Jesus, he's a God of restoration. Maybe the helper you needed are the ministers that have come your way today now. You never know. Maybe we are the helpers God has sent to you. The Bible said Peter and John said to him, they said, we don't have silver, we don't have gold. But what we have, we will give you. In the name of Jesus, rise up. Rise up, rise up, rise up. And the Bible said they took him by the hand and lifted him up, and his ankle, his feet, his ankle bones received strength, received strength. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. You are rising again. Receive strength in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, the devil will not be able to steal your strength anymore. He will not steal your strength anymore in the name of Jesus Christ. Isaiah chapter 40. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Isaiah chapter 40. Chapter 40, verse 31. The Bible says, but they that wait upon the Lord. Uh-huh. Before that, he said, the youth will be weary, the young men will utterly fall. And he said so many things. He said, but now in verse 31, he said, but they that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. They shall mount up. Yes, you may not see yourself. You say, okay, they have come again. I'm not the one they are talking to. You are the one we are talking to. If we are not just talking, God has sent us with this word for you. In the name of Jesus, rise up. Rise up, shake up yourself from the dust, you captive daughter of Zion. Shake up yourself from the dust. Shake up yourself from the dust, for it is time to serve him. It is time to rise. It is time to rise. It is time to rise. In the name of Jesus, he said, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run. These were people that were on the floor before. These were people that didn't have strength. These were men that utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run. They shall not be weary. They shall walk. Whichever one you are doing, but they shall walk. And they shall not faint. In the name of Jesus, I decree and I declare upon your life, your strength is restored. The strength in your health is restored. Strength in your mind restored. Ayamanoko se bahaya. Elegedege boshiba radakata. Likatoze barando kosida. Ye kama mama nakata. Your strength is renewed. Your strength is restored right now in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. Listen, let me tell you something. It doesn't matter what took that strength away before. Let me tell you something. It doesn't matter what took that strength away from you, but that devil is a liar. The Lord sent me to you with this word. As I prophesy upon your life, that same situation, that same issue, that same matter that took away your strength, I decree their end now. Anakadeke sugaba. Receive strength. Receive strength. Receive strength. Do you understand what ankle bones are? Do you understand what feet represent? The Bible says they had to lift him up because he had been in that situation right from birth. He had been in that situation. He was his feet was used to being in that condition. His ankle bones have already gone weak and tired because they've not been used for years. But the scripture said, If a man dies, shall he live again? But all the days of my appointed time will I wait till my change come. And the scripture said that if you cut a tree down, the place which it falleth, whether to the north or the south, there shall it be. He said, but at the scent of water, it will sprout again. Water bring that strength in the name that is above every other name. Let your strength be restored to you now. Let your strength be restored to you now. God is not a man that he should lie. He is not the son of man that he should repent. Has he said, and shall he not do it? Has he spoken, and shall he not make it good? Behold, I have received a commandment to bless, and he has blessed, and I cannot reverse it. I speak into your life in the name of Jesus. Let your feet receive strength. Feet is that which carries people. Feet is that which man used to move from point A to point B. Your ankle bones are what gives your feet that life to stand. In the name of Jesus, receive strength again in that area of your life. Receive strength again in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, woe to him that put his trust upon man. You know why he said woe to him? He said, for vain is the help of man. Vain is the help of man. He didn't say, look unto pastor. He didn't say, look unto the apostle. He didn't say, look unto that man, that woman, that boy, that girl, that employer. No, he said, looking unto Jesus. The author and the finisher of our faith. I speak into your life by the order of heaven. Let strength come back into you. Let strength come back into you in the name of Jesus. In psychology, there is what we call reason for living. That no matter how somebody is going through precarious situations, going through death-threatening, life-threatening situations, you know, you get to that person and you look at the person, you ask him one question. What is your reason for living? Do you have a reason for living? Listen, let me tell you something. If the person tells you he doesn't have a reason for living and you cannot be able to present to that person a reason for living, I am telling you that person is going. But if that person have one reason to live, Ayana Makata, daily as I live, as often as I breathe, Ayama Maya, let my whole life the expressions of your grace. Shabadi alege yada bayada. Daily as I live, hey, as often as I breathe, hey, let my whole life be expression of your grace. We cry, Abba Father, hey, hallowed be your name. Hallowed be your name. Hallowed be your name. I cry, Abba Father, hallowed be your name. Hallowed be your name. Hallowed be your name. Hear me. Hear me. If there is one reason, if there is one reason, that person you will come the following day is still breathing. It doesn't matter what diagnosis they give to that person. He will come next week. He is still living. You come 2 months. He is still living. You come 10 months. He is still living. Listen. Esther said, if I perish, I perish. Those who say, if I perish, I perish, never perish. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. Let strength be renewed. Let strength be restored to you. Let strength be restored to you in your spirit, in your soul, in your body. Let strength be restored. Receive strength in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. My God, we worship you. My Father, we give you the praise and the glory. Mandoko sokelia da bakata. Yeke deke shobalia da kase. Imbreke doko soli barakata. Yege de barus geande kata. Leso borondi gedia da kata. Mekitu zatia da bakata. Sometimes we don't know how close we are to the breakthrough that we are crying for. You see, the time some people gave up. The time some people gave up, if they had known how close they are, how close they were to the testimony, to their breakthrough, they would have said, oh, he's so close. Elisha said, he said unto God and said, Father, please open the eyes of this servant. He's disturbing me too much. He does not see what I see. Lord, if we see the same thing, we will move faster. We will do better. We will not be in a hurry. We will relax. For greater they that are with us are more than those that are with them. And the Bible says, and the Lord opened the eyes of the servant, and he saw chariots and horses of fire. He screamed, my father, my father, my father, my father, the chariot of Israel and the horsemen thereof. Listen to me. Strength is restored back to you now. Strength is restored back to you now. May God open your eyes to see things that you can't see. May God open your eyes to see that which you are chasing, how close it is to you. In the name of Jesus Christ, my God, we thank you. My God, we worship you. I'd like you to do something now. Do something quick. I'd like you to lift up your two hands and say, I am strong. Say it again. I am strong. Say it the third time. I am strong. Say it the fourth time. I am strong. Yes, again, I am strong. Yet the sixth time, I am strong. Shout it the seventh time. I am strong. You are. You are. Your strength is back. You are renewed like the eagle. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name. Begin to worship him. Begin to give him the praise. Give him the praise. Give him the glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We cry, Abba, Father. Hey.